Introducing the Black Panther Flicker. And it also can boomerang. I started trying to design this Black Panther, or it could be a jaguar, by requesting my origami student Atharv during his Zoom tutoring session with me. And at the end of a half hour, this is how far we'd gotten. Atharv's favorite animal is a jaguar, and so we just made a jaguar head, and it's also a flicker.
Ooh.
Oh yeah, okay. Yeah, that's good. After Atharv's session with me, I decided to try to refine the model, and after about 15 tries, I was finally satisfied, and here's the finished Black Panther flicker alongside the Google image I was aiming for. So this is the final version of the Black Panther face that I'm going to teach in this tutorial. This was folded from a 6-inch square, but for clarity, I'm going to teach you how to fold it from a 10-inch square of Kami. So it'll end up looking like this. You could also use a sheet of printer paper cut square. So begin, wide side up, and fold in half. Try to make really precise folds and crease sharply. Unfold and repeat in this direction. Now this is a rather challenging model, so if you're new to folding, I'd recommend trying some of my easier models. But if you're up for the challenge, let's continue. Unfold, and we're making a fish face. So fold this edge to this edge, but just fold from the corner to the crease. And now pinch the corner here and continue the fold to this corner. And flatten. And repeat. Make sure that the edges touch. Crease sharply. Turn over and fold the two corners to the middle. And fold these two corners to the middle. All right, now these diagonal edges are on the left, so we're going to unfold the right flap and turn over and open and squash on this existing crease. And now put your finger in the pocket and squash so that this crease lands on this edge. And repeat. Turn over and fold this edge to the middle. Hold the layers down so that they don't slide. And repeat. Unfold these two flaps and fold these two flaps outward. Turn over and pinch on this crease. And now fold, aligning with this edge. And flatten. And repeat. Turn over, rotate, and fold this whole flap up on these two points. Make sure that you're straight by a lining here. Turn over and unfold this flap, rotate, and fold this flap between this point and this point. Unfold and repeat. Unfold and now rabbit ear. And flatten. And flatten to the other side. Now fold this edge onto the crease. Hold the layers down so they don't slide. And make sure that this corner touches the middle crease. Unfold and open here and pinch on this crease. And squash. Open here and make this crease as a mountain. So pinch and fold it onto the middle line. And repeat. Fold this flap between these two points. And fold this flap so this edge aligns with this edge. And fold from this point to this point. Unfold and repeat. Unfold, rotate, and now fold this flap down. We're folding so that these two creases touch these two edges. And make sure this point touches the middle line. And unfold and fold this corner to this point. And bring it back down. And now fold on the existing crease. And make a fold from this point to this point. And repeat. All right, so it's like that. And now make a paper airplane fold. So fold like this. Lift this flap up and fold this flap on these two points. Unfold it and open like this, and same on this side, and squash. Fold this flap up and tuck it into the pocket. We're not tucking it all the way in. We're leaving a little bit of space like that. Now unfold these two flaps and unfold this flap. And fold between this point and the middle. And and repeat. And now open the nostrils. So I'm going to use a pencil. So open it and just fold the edge down like that. And same on this side. Okay, there are the nostrils. Now we're going to work on the eyes. So fold this edge to this edge just as much as you can. And it's going to squash, so like that. And now fold this edge to this edge. And squash. And open. And just shape it round like an eye. Or however you want to shape it. Like a triangle, I guess. And repeat. Alright, so there's the eyes, the nose, and now fold this flap so that this edge aligns with the crease. And repeat. Turn over. Fold this edge so that it's parallel to this edge. It doesn't touch, about like this. And flatten, about like that. Just however you can flatten it so it looks something like that is good. And repeat. All right, now fold this flap so that this edge touches this point and it's perpendicular to this edge and this edge. And fold this flap so that this edge aligns with this edge. And fold this flap behind so it aligns with this edge. And tuck the flap into the pocket. Like that, and repeat. So we're folding like this. All right, now fold this flap aligning with this edge. And repeat. And turn over. And now take the flap and we're going to fold it out. So we're folding on this point and we want to fold it so that this edge touches this edge. So it's like that. I'm going to unfold so that you see the pleat. But we actually want these folds to be reversed. So make this be a mountain fold and wrap it over the edge and tuck it inside. And repeat. So fold like this. Make the edges touch. Unfold and make this be a mountain fold. Fold it over the edge and unfold and tuck it in. And we can round the ears a little bit by folding over like this to taste. All right, now fold this flap. We want the corner to touch this edge and fold from this point to this point, and then fold from this point to this point. Unfold, we're making the mouth. So turn over and rotate. And now pinch on the middle like this. We're not folding this flap. We're just folding these layers. And now we're going to fold to this point where this crease and this crease intersect. So it tapers right there, and we're folding this edge to the point, just from here to here. I'm gonna unfold so you see what it looks like. And now take this edge and fold it to this point. Again, just folding from here to here. And now make these folds again. And make the pleat. And now collapse the pleat so that these corners touch these edges. And turn over, and you can see the mouth is forming. Turn back over. All right, now we're going to fold this edge so it aligns with this edge. So it's like this, and squash like this. So it was like this, and we squashed like that. And repeat. And turn over and fold this flap up as far as it goes. And now fold it back down so that it forms a little mouth right there. And tuck these two corners into the mouth like that. And fold this behind, and you can round it to taste. And fold this corner behind to taste, and repeat. And fold this corner behind to taste, but we're folding on this point. So like that, and repeat. And fold this corner behind to taste. All right, so if you like it like that, you're done, but if you want to round it some more, then that would probably be good. So, especially right here, because that will lock the corners together. And here. I'm not going to round this corner. All right, and there it is. Ooh, it balances on my finger. And it can flick, but you guys can experiment with that. It doesn't flick too well because it has this big flap here. If you fold it in like that, then that might keep it down better. But I think it looks nice 3D like that, so it looks a little more realistic. All right, so to fly this Black Panther, I recommend hitting it on the top of the head, right on the side, so it gives it lots of spin. Let's see. Yeah. Now, if you want to get it to boomerang, then tilt it upwards and a little bit to the left and give it lots of spin. Like that. Yeah. Yeah. Hope you guys were able to fold this and hope you enjoy flying it, and I'll see you later.